Hi guys, and welcome back to Bitesize Excel. This week we're going to take another look at Power Query. And in particular, we're going to look at how you can summarise multiple tables in a chart to create either a summary table, or maybe a pivot table, or a pivot chart. If you're new to Power Query, I'd suggest checking out some of my other Power Query videos, which I'll link to in the description below, and I'll also link to the playlist at the end of the video. But for now, let's jump right in. So first we're going to look at how I've set up the data in this workbook so that we can quickly and easily use Power Query to summarise it. So I've got five tabs here, from 2016 through to 2020. And in each workbook I have two tables. One is a list of items and the categories they fall into, item cost, item sold, total saved. And just for illustrative purposes, I've added in this last column, which is basically whether I want it included in the summary or not. I then have a second table that summarises those categories with a sum if. And each tab is set up in the exact same way. Now to make my Power Query really, really simple to summarise, what I've done, I've named each of these tables. So if I come over here to Table Design, you'll see that I've named this table Sales 2016. And the bottom table is Summary 2016. And then on each individual tab, each of those tables is named using the exact same convention. And this is really important because this is what allows us to summarise really quickly. So moving on to the Power Query bits. Now first we need to get all these tables into Power Query. And there's no need to go through each individual table and load them in separately. There's a much quicker way of doing this. So what we do is we come to our Data tab. And we go to Get Data, which is a drop down. And what we do is come down to From Other Sources and come down to Blank Query. And when we click on that, we get our Power Query Editor opening. And to get everything in your workbook that is named, so this will include all your tables and your named ranges. If you want to know a little bit more about named ranges and naming tables, I do have a video which I will also link to in the description. But essentially you can type something really quick and simple into the bar at the top here, which will pull in all the named data. And that is equals. If we start typing Excel, it does need to be a capital. And you'll see that it starts autofilling Excel.currentWorkbook. And the capitals are the E, the C of the current, and the W of the workbook. But I can actually just hover over that and press Tab, and it will complete it for me. I then want to open and close a bracket. And if I hit enter, what will happen is it will pull up everything in my workbook that is a named either table or named range. And you can see that I had five tabs with two tables on each, and there's 10 different records here. And what we want to do now is tidy up this data. So I'm just going to move my name to the front, and then I want to filter it so that I just have my sales data, so I could either check them automatically here, but if you have loads and loads of worksheets, you probably want to come over to Begins With, and we want the tables that begin with sales. Click OK. And there we go. We've just got five rows left now. And I'm actually going to rename everything in here to remove the sales. So I want to come to Replace Values. So right clicking on the top here, come to Replace Values. And I want to replace sales with nothing. Click OK. And I will just have the year. I'm then going to expand out this column by clicking on this little button at the top. And it will give me the option to pick what I want to expand out. For now, we'll just leave it as everything. If you click on load more, it's actually loaded everything up already, so that doesn't really matter. I'm going to uncheck this box because I don't want to use the original column name as a prefix. And I'll click OK. And you'll see there I have all my items. So everything from those tables has now gone into my Power Pivot. To do a little bit further tidying up, I don't want to include my total rows. So I'm going to exclude everything that's got a total in it there. Everything else I want to leave the same, except this last column, which I included for illustrative purposes, and say there's stuff I don't want to include, I can uncheck that. And it will remove those from my list. So we've got 55 rows in this. If you want to then remove this column, still got 55 rows there. And if there was anything else you wanted to exclude, you could do it at this point. But for now, what I'm going to do is close and load. And you'll see now I have this table in, which summarises all my data from my different workbooks into a single table. Now say I wanted to create a pivot chart using the data in the second tables, we can follow the exact same steps that we did before. So come into our data tab, get data from other sources and blank query. Then we want to go through the same thing, so equals Excel, current workbook, open and close my brackets and hit enter. And you'll see I've got all my tables there again, and it's also picked up that query one table. One thing you could also do, you can rename your query so it's a bit more obvious. So say I want to call this one summary, and I'm going to filter it so it's just everything that begins with summary. And if we move it over, expand this, and I'm going to uncheck this again, click OK. Tidy up this column in the same way that we did last time, so replace values and take out the summary this time. And I want to filter out those totals. What we're then going to do is when we hit close and load, so we're going to go close and load to, and we get this dialog box, which allows us to select how we want to load it, so a table, a pivot table, or a pivot chart. We're going to click pivot chart, put it into a new worksheet, click OK. And now we're going to be able to see our summary data within a chart. So say if I add it in, change my data series, so say I want this on a second column and to be a line, click OK, and there we've got it added in. So this is summarising all that data in your second tables. And you can adjust your pivot table in the same way that you can adjust a normal pivot table. Again, I've got loads of videos on pivot tables if you'd like to check them out. But moving on next to adding new data. Now, one of the benefits of summarising data using Power Query is it becomes really simple when you want to add in new data. So say I now want to create some 2021 data. So I'm going to just copy this workbook, I'm going to move it to the end, and I'm going to rename it as 2021. I'm then going to go to each of my tables and make sure that I've updated the naming convention. So this is going to be sales 2021. And this is going to be summary 2021. And say I also want to add in some new data in here. So let's add a couple of extra rows in. So we'll call that one item 13. And this one, item 14. And say I want to add a new category in as well. So I'm going to call this one category 5. And then we're going to select these as category 5. And I'll just add in some random figures here. And we'll put all these to yes. Now what's going to happen is when I refresh my data, it should add into these original queries and the summary one. So to do that, we go back to our data tab and click on refresh all. And you can see now that I've had category 5 being added in on this table. And if I come back to query 1 and scroll down, you'll see now that we have in 2021, we've got those items 13 and 14 and category 5 in there as well. So you can see how quick and simple that was just to add some new data in. So this has been a quick introduction to how you can summarize data really quickly using Power Query. As always, if you've got any questions at all, please do leave me a comment below. I'd also love to hear your suggestions for future videos. Do remember to like and subscribe, as it does really help me out as a fairly new content creator. I hope that you found this useful, and I do look forward to seeing you on the next video.